finally I am making it only for you guys. Make sure you watch this video till the end, because this video is going to give you a lot of information and you can easily get more than 140 marks in NSET if you watch this complete video. So make sure you watch this video till the end. Now let's begin this video without any delay, okay? So first let's see in this video what all we are going to discuss, okay? First, so we are going to discuss NSET exam day rules, okay? All the new rules which are launched this year specially, I'm going to discuss all of them with you. And then let's see what are subject wise important topics and subject wise tips to score good in that particular subject, and also what are the best books for that particular subject. And then let's see how to score 140 plus marks in NSET. And then let's see cheat codes, tips and tricks, and then last minute preparation tips, marks versus rank. I'm also going to tell you the study plan for these last few days where you can easily get a very good rank by following that particular study plan. Let's see NSET cutoff for this particular year, okay? First instruction is each and every candidate must carry a simple pen, okay? Only a simple ball pen you must carry. Okay, they are going to allow only simple pens to the exam, and you need to carry your own mask and sanitizer. Okay, so this is first important rule. Most important thing is you must reach exam center at least before 1 hour. Okay, why? Because they are going to check your temperature, they are going to make thermal screening, and this year especially you need to undergo many process and protocols, surely going to take much time. That too, they are not going to allow all the students at a time into exam hall. They will allow students in slots, okay? So that's why it will surely take some time. Better you have to reach exam center minimum before 1 hour. They are going to capture your photograph during registration process, okay? So next important thing is make sure you carry your ID proof and admit card, okay? ID what? Now let's see what are valid ID proofs. Valid ID proofs are Aadhaar, voter ID, driving license, all these things come under valid ID proof. You must carry your valid ID proof, and also you must carry your admit card along with you. Okay. Now let's see what are the most important topics subject wise. Okay. So first let's see for maths. After this we are going to see for physics, chemistry and biology. Okay. So coming to maths, first most important topic is differential calculus. Differential calculus, okay, very important topic. And next is integral calculus. Integral calculus, very important. And last important topic is calculus. Okay, so from these topics, if you follow all these three topics, you are going to at least get 90% in your NSET maths paper. Okay, these are very important topics coming to NSET mathematics. Now let's see what are the mathematics tips. Okay, what are the tips to score good marks in mathematics? First important tip is you need to revise formula daily. Revise all the formula daily. Most important tip. Why? Because only when you remember the formula, you can solve the problem. That's why, first of all, you need to memorize the formula. Second important tip for mathematics is speed up your calculation. Speed up your calculation. Why? Because when you speed up your calculation, it saves a lot of time. When you solve a problem within less time, it will save a lot of time, and in that leftover time you can start solving other questions. Okay, so speeding up your calculations will save lot of time. Okay, and next important thing is you must practice each and every question. Okay, next is practice. Okay, regular practice is very important. Next is follow Insert Mathematics. Insert Mathematics books will really help you to get very good score in maths. So follow Insert Mathematics. Okay, next important thing is concentrate on difficult problems. So concentrate on difficult topics and work on weak topics. Okay, so whatever topics you feel as weak, first start preparing from those topics. So now let's see what are best books for maths. So coming to the best books for maths, first is MCET Mathematics by Arihant Experts. Second important book is Problems Plus in IIT Mathematics by A. Das Gupta. Next, Handbook of Mathematics by Arihant Experts. Okay, so these three books are standard books coming to mathematics. Okay, now let's see what are the most important topics coming to physics. Okay, so coming to physics, first important topic is motion in a plane. This is very, very important topic. Next is laws of motion. Next, work energy and power. System of particle and rotational motion. System of particles and rotational motion. Okay, next is thermodynamics. Next is moving charges and magnetism. These are most important topics coming to physics. Okay, so now let's see what are the best books for physics. So first is MCET Physics by Arihant Experts. Next is Concepts of Physics Volume 1 and Volume 2 by H.C. Verma. So these books are standard and best books coming to physics. Okay, so now let's see what are the physics tips to score good marks in physics. Okay, so first important thing is topic wise formula. Okay, what does this mean? From each and every topic we will be having formula, right? So all those formula topic wise, make a note and keep studying them daily. Okay, next important tip is go through academy books. Okay, that is specially go through IPE textbooks, because most of the topics will be asked from IPE textbooks. Okay, and next most important thing is complete maths, chemistry or biology within within 1 hour 45 minutes. Okay. So next important tip is you need to complete rest of your paper. That is coming to MPC students, you need to complete mathematics and chemistry paper within less than 1 hour 45 minutes. Okay. And coming to BIPC students, you must complete your biology and chemistry paper within less than 45 minutes. Why? Because physics will surely take some time. Okay. That's why rest all papers, if you complete at least in 1 hour 45 minutes, rest of the time you can happily concentrate only on physics and solve the paper relaxedly so that you can get the best score in physics. Okay. And next important thing is start preparing toughest topics. Whatever topics I told as important, in those particular topics, whatever you feel as tough, start from those topics, okay? First, start your preparation from toughest topics and then go to easy topics, okay? First, you need to start your preparation with tough topics, okay? In the physics subject, we'll be having only 10 to 20% of difficult topics. If you want to ignore them, you can ignore those topics, okay? You can study remaining 80 to 90% of easy and moderate topics and you can ignore 10 to 20% of difficult topics, okay? So now let's see what are the most important topics for chemistry. First most important topic is atomic structure and chemical bonding. Atomic structure and chemical bonding. Okay. So next is thermodynamics. Thermodynamics. Whatever topics I am telling you, they are very, very important. Next is gaseous and liquid state. Next is solutions, hydrocarbon, next is classification of elements, and periodicity in properties, P block and B block elements. Okay. Next is carbolic acid, polymers. Okay. These are the most important topics coming to chemistry, and you can also take the screenshot if you want. Okay. Now let's see what are the best books for chemistry. So coming to the chemistry best books, first one is MCET Chemistry by Arihant Experts. Next is Organic Chemistry 7th edition by Robert Thornton Morrison. Next is Fundamentals of Inorganic Chemistry by Ananya Ganguly. Okay, so these three books are very important. So now let's see what are the most important tips in order to score good marks in chemistry. Okay. So first thing is concentrate on laws and reactions. It is very important to concentrate on laws and reactions. Okay. So next important thing is practice from insert chemistry book. Insert chemistry book will really help you to get a very good score. So concentrate on insert chemistry books. And next is read from IPE books also, because 50 to 60% of the concepts will be asked from IPE books. Okay. And next is learn the concepts. Okay. Most of the questions will be asked from the concepts. So learn concepts. Okay. Now let's see what are the most important topics for botany. Okay, so coming to botany, first important topic is diversity in living world. Diversity in living world. Okay, so next is morphology of flowering plants. Morphology of flowering plants. Okay, so next is reproduction in plants. Next is molecular biology. Molecular biology, biotechnology and its applications. Biotechnology and its applications. Okay, so last but not least, plants, microbes and human welfare. Plants, microbes and human welfare. Okay, these are the most important topics coming to botany. Okay, just take a quick screenshot. Next is zoology. Okay, so next is zoology. So zoology most important topics are body fluids and circulation. Body fluids and circulation. Human reproductive system. Human reproductive system. Okay. Study of Periplaneta Americana. Okay, it's nothing but cockroach. Okay, next is diversity of living world. Diversity of living world. Okay, digestion and absorption. Okay, so next is breathing and respiration. Breathing and respiration. Okay, so next is muscular and skeletal system. Muscular and skeleton system. Last but not least, organic evolution. Organic evolution. So students, take a quick screenshot and let's make this video reach 1k likes. Okay, so now let's see what are the best books for biology. Okay, first one is NSET Crash Course Biology by Annapurna Experts. Next is Modern ABC of Biology Class 12th, which has two parts. Okay, both the parts you must study. This book is written by A. Das Gupta. And next is Complete Biology for NEET and Other Medical Entrance Examinations by Kumar Bhatia. ACE Biology, that is ACE, ACE Biology for NEET Medical Entrance Exams by Narang RC. Okay, see, few students are asking me to give study plan. All important topics I have told for you in this video. those topics, make sure you complete based upon your days left for your exam. Okay, so for example, let's think you have 5 days left for your exam. Then within 5 days, how much ever important topics I told for you, make sure within 5 days at least you complete those topics. Okay, if you have 10 days for exam, within 10 days complete the important topics. Okay, so based because AP MCET and TS MCET exam dates are different, so based upon the days left for you for exam, based on that you need to schedule your own study plan. Okay, let's see how to score 140 plus marks in MCET. After this we are going to see what are last minute preparation tips for MCET and what are cheat codes, MCET marks versus rank and MCET cutoff. Okay, so watch this video till the end, and from this particular topic I'm going to explain in English as well as in Telugu. Okay, in both the languages I'm going to explain, because most of the Telugu students are requesting me to explain in Telugu also. So from this particular topic I'll explain in both English and Telugu. Okay, now let's see how to score 140 mark, 140 plus marks in MCET. MCET low 140 kanna ekku marks ela techkovalo ippudu chusedam. First is concentrate on weak topics and subjects. Weak topics and subjects. ఏ సబ్జెక్ట్స్ లో అయితే మీరు వీక్ గా ఉన్నారో, ఏ టాపిక్స్ అయితే మీరు వీక్ గా ఉన్నారో, ఫస్ట్ మీరు ఆ టాపిక్స్ నుంచి చదవడం మొదలు పెట్టండి. ఎందుకంటే అన్ని సబ్జెక్ట్స్ లో కూడా మనకి మంచి మార్క్స్ వస్తే అప్పుడే మనకి 140 మార్కుల కన్నా ఎక్కువ ఎంసెట్ లో వచ్చే ఛాన్స్ ఉంటుంది. సో వాట్ ఎవర్ టాపిక్స్ యూ ఫీల్ యాజ్ వీక్ ఆర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ సబ్జెక్ట్స్ యూ ఆర్ నాట్ కాన్ఫిడెంట్ విత్, ఫస్ట్ స్టార్ట్ ప్రిపేరింగ్ విత్ దోస్ థింగ్స్. ఓకే, సో నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ సాల్వ్ ఈజీ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఫస్ట్. Solve easy questions first. Okay, so once you get the question paper, start solving the easy questions. Why? Because once you solve all the easy questions, the leftover time you can concentrate on difficult questions. Okay, if you start solving with difficult questions, all the time will be wasted. Okay, so at last you will not be left with the time and you cannot solve easy questions also. That's why first start solving easy questions and then go to difficult questions. Okay, so exam paper, exam start avangane first meeru easy questions anevi solve cheyandi. Easy questions mundu solve chesthe tarvata ee time aithe migulutado aa time lo difficult questions, kashtakaramaina questions solve cheyachu. Ala kaakunda meeru first కష్టమైన క్వశ్చన్ స్టార్ట్ చేస్తే అందులోనే టైం అంతా అయిపోతుంది. తర్వాత మీరు ఈజీ క్వశ్చన్స్, సులభమైన క్వశ్చన్స్ సాల్వ్ చేయడానికి అసలు మీకు టైం అనేదే మిగలదు. అందుకే ఫస్ట్ మీరు ఈజీ క్వశ్చన్స్తో పేపర్ మొదలు పెట్టండి. ఓకే, సో నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ కాన్సన్ట్రేట్ ఆన్ హై వెయిటేజ్ టాపిక్స్. కాన్సన్ట్రేట్ ఆన్ హై వెయిటేజ్ టాపిక్స్. Concentrate on high weightage topics. And does this mean every subject will have high weightage questions and low weightage questions? High weightage questions means from those particular topic more questions will be asked. Those kind of topics are called high weightage topics. Concentrate on those topics, because if you just study high weightage topics also you are going to get more than 80% of marks in MCET. Okay, so manaki anni subject lo kuda హై వెయిటేజ్ టాపిక్స్ అనే ఉంటాయి. హై వెయిటేజ్ టాపిక్స్ అంటే ఏంటంటే ఆ టాపిక్స్ నుంచి ఎక్కువ ప్రశ్నలు అడుగుతారు ఎగ్జామ్లో. అలాంటి టాపిక్స్ కనుక చదవడం మొదలు పెడితే మనకి ఈజీగా 80 నుంచి 90% మార్క్స్ ఎంసెట్లో వచ్చేస్తాయి. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ డోంట్ స్పెండ్ మచ్ టైమ్ ఆన్ సింగిల్ క్వశ్చన్. Okay, what does this mean? See, we already know there is limited time for MCET. In that limited time we need to solve all the questions from all the subjects. If you start wasting just by sitting with one question, the time will pass and you will not have time left in order to solve other questions. So first only before going to exam center, before the exam day only, fix your mind how much time you wanted to allocate for single question. After that time, you don't waste on that particular question, just proceed with next question. Okay, మనకి కొంచెం టైమే ఉంటుంది ఎంసెట్లో, ఆ ఇచ్చిన టైంలోనే మనము అన్ని క్వశ్చన్స్ అనేవి సాల్వ్ చేయాలి. మీరు ఒకే క్వశ్చన్ దగ్గర స్టక్ అయిపోయి ఒకే క్వశ్చన్ దగ్గర ఆగిపోతే వేరే క్వశ్చన్స్ సాల్వ్ చేయడానికి టైం ఉండదు. అందుకే మీరు ఎగ్జామ్ ముందు రోజే మీరు ఫిక్స్ అవ్వండి ఏ క్వశ్చన్కి ఒక్కొక్క క్వశ్చన్కి ఎంత టైం ఇవ్వాలో. ఆ టైం అవ్వగానే మీరు నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్కి వెళ్ళిపోవాలి, ఆ క్వశ్చన్ దగ్గర స్టక్ అవ్వకూడదు. ఓకేనా? సో నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ థింక్ అండ్ ఆన్సర్. Think and answer means see few questions. When you study for the first time, you will not get the idea. Okay, those kind of questions try to read twice or thrice so that you will get idea about the question and you can solve the question. Okay, so think and answer ante entante manaki konni konni questions lo first time chadavagane idea raavu, alanti question lo rendu moodu saarlu chadavute manaki aa concept anedi gurtochi. Okay, so next is prioritize. What does this mean? What is meant by prioritize? Prioritize means you have to first decide from which subject you wanted to solve the question paper. Okay, this is meant by prioritize. Next is read question carefully. What is meant by this? See, few questions will be logical. Okay, for example, let's think there is a question. In the first question, they may ask choose the correct option, or they may ask choose incorrect option. If we miss out reading incorrect or correct, whatever option you choose, that's going to be wrong. These two questions are completely different. If you don't read the question carefully, your answer is going to be wrong. That's why make sure you read the question carefully. Okay, next important thing is spend first few minutes to read the question paper. Okay, why? Because once you read the question paper, you will understand the difficulty level of the question paper and you can understand whether the paper is easy, moderate or lengthy. Okay, based on that you can allocate time adequately. Okay, so first few minutes spend to read question paper completely. Okay, so coming to last minute preparation tips, first most important tip is don't start new topics. See, when you are left only with few days or few weeks for your exam, so it's better not to start any new topic, because if you start any new topic, you will be confused and you will also tend to forget the things which you have already studied. So don't go with new topics. Okay, so second important thing is study important topics. And next important thing is refer to short notes. Okay, whatever short notes you prepared while your preparation, just go through that short notes and revise it quickly. Okay, mock tests. Next important tip is mock tests and analyze your mock test. Okay, it's very important to take the mock test, because only once you take the mock test, you will understand are you able to solve the paper and how much time you're taking to solve the paper or to solve a particular question, and are you getting stuck in any particular topic or subject. All these things you will get to know only when once you take mock test. Okay, so first take mock test, and after taking mock test, analyze your mock test and make sure you don't repeat those mistakes in final exam. Okay, so next is go through previous papers are very important, because more than 40% of similar kind of questions and its patterns will be asked every year. So it's always good to refer to at least last 4 to 5 years previous papers. Okay, so next important tip is Don't study for long hours. Don't study the same subject for long hours. Okay. So once you study the same subject or same topic for long hours, nothing will go into your mind. Just keep changing the topics or subjects frequently. Okay. And make sure at least once in every 2 hours, take a short break. Okay. Revise. Okay. The things which you have already studied, revise them thoroughly. Revision helps you to memorize the things which you have already studied. Okay. Make sure you arrange all the essential things day before exam only. Okay. Your admit card, your ID proof, all these things. Make sure you arrange them before exam day only so that there will be no tension on the exam day. And see the same in Telugu. Don't start new topics అంటే లాస్ట్ మినిట్లో కొత్త టాపిక్స్ చదవడం మొదలు పెట్టకండి. ఎందుకంటే మీరు లాస్ట్ మినిట్లో కొత్త టాపిక్స్ అనేది చదవడం స్టార్ట్ చేస్తే కన్ఫ్యూజన్ అనేది వస్తుంది అండ్ ఏవైతే చదివారో అవి కూడా మర్చిపోతారు. నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి స్టడీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ టాపిక్స్ అంటే కొన్ని టాపిక్స్లోంచి ఎక్కువ క్వశ్చన్స్ అయితే వస్తాయి. అలాంటి టాపిక్స్ని చూస్ చేసుకుని అవే చదవండి. అవి మాత్రం విడిచిపెట్టద్దు. ఎందుకంటే ఒక్క టాపిక్ చదివితే దాంట్లో మనకి ఎక్కువ క్వశ్చన్స్ అనేవి వస్తాయి. సో అవి ఈజీగా మనం అటెంప్ట్ చేసేయచ్చు. నెక్స్ట్ ఏంటంటే షార్ట్ నోట్స్. షార్ట్ నోట్స్ అంటే ఏంటంటే మనం చదువుకునేటప్పుడు మీరు చదువుకునేటప్పుడు షార్ట్ నోట్స్ ఏవైతే ప్రిపేర్ చేసి పెట్టుకున్నారో అన్నీ ఒకసారి రివైజ్ చేసుకోండి. నెక్స్ట్ మాక్ టెస్ట్. మాక్ టెస్ట్ వల్ల లాభం ఏంటంటే మీరు ఎక్కడైనా స్టక్ అవుతున్నారా, ఏ క్వశ్చన్ దగ్గరైనా ఎంత టైం తీసుకుంటున్నారు మీరు క్వశ్చన్కి, ఇవన్నీ కూడా మనకి అర్థమవుతాయి. అందుకే మాక్ టెస్ట్ తీసుకోండి. మాక్ టెస్ట్ రాసిన తర్వాత అందులో ఏవైతే మిస్టేక్స్ చేస్తున్నారో అవి ఎనలైజ్ చేసుకుని అవి మెయిన్ ఎగ్జామ్లో రిపీట్ చేయకుండా ఉండడానికి ట్రై చేయండి. నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ప్రీవియస్ పేపర్స్. ప్రీవియస్ పేపర్స్ చదివితే చాలా హెల్ప్ఫుల్ అవుతుంది. ఎలాంటి క్వశ్చన్స్ వస్తున్నాయి, ఎలాంటి టాపిక్స్ నుంచి వస్తున్నాయి, ఇవన్నీ కూడా మీకు అర్థమవుతాయి. సో ప్రీవియస్ పేపర్స్ అనేవి తప్పకుండా చదవండి. అట్లీస్ట్ లాస్ట్ 4 to 5 years ప్రీవియస్ పేపర్స్ చదవండి. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ డోంట్ స్టడీ ఫర్ లాంగ్ అవర్స్. ఓకే, ఒకటే సబ్జెక్ట్ తీసుకుని ఎక్కువ గంటలు కంటిన్యూస్గా చదివితే బ్రెయిన్లోకి ఏమీ వెళ్ళదు. అందుకని సబ్జెక్టు ఒక 2-3 గంటలకి మారుస్తూ ఉండండి. అండ్ లాస్ట్ వచ్చేసి రివిజన్. రివిజన్ బాగా చేసుకోండి. రివైజ్ ఎంత బాగా చేసుకుంటే అంత తొందరగా మనకి ఎగ్జామ్లో ఆన్సర్స్ అనేవి గుర్తొస్తాయి. సో నౌ లెట్స్ సీ ఎంసెట్ చీట్ కోడ్. ఓకే, ఫస్ట్ ఐ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ద చీట్ కోడ్ ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్, దెన్ ఐ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ద సేమ్ ఇన్ తెలుగు ఆల్సో. ముందుగా ఈ చీట్ కోడ్ నేను ఇంగ్లీష్లో చెప్తానండి, తర్వాత నేను తెలుగులో కూడా ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేస్తాను. ఓకే, సో ఫస్ట్ వీ ఆల్ నో దాట్ దెర్ విల్ బి 160 questions ఇన్ ద ఎగ్జామ్. ఓకే, we all know this, 160 questions are going to be in the exam, and we also know there will be 4 options. Okay, so all the 4 options will be repeating 40 times in a question paper. Okay, A will repeat 40 times in the question paper, B will appear 40 times, C will appear 40 times, D will be the answer for 40 questions. Okay, so all together 160 questions. Okay, 160 questions in the exam paper, and the options for the questions will be A, B, C and D. And in overall question paper, option A will be the answer for 40 questions. Option B will be the answer for 40 questions. Option C will be the answer for 40 questions. And option D will be for 40 questions. Okay, now let's take an example. Let's think you kept answer A for 35 questions. Option B for 15 questions. Option C for 25 questions, option D for 30 questions. Okay, let's think a student kept option A 35 times in the question paper, option B 15 times in the question paper, option C 25 times in the question paper, and option D 30 times a question paper. But see, first let's take A as example. In overall question paper, option A will be the answer for 40 different questions. Okay, so but you selected Option A, only for 35 questions. So for remaining 5 questions also, you can select option A as answer. So totally it will be 40. Okay. So next is option B, you kept 15 times, but in overall the paper, the option B will be 40 times. Or 20 times you can put option B as answer. Totally it will be 40. Okay. So same with this also, 15 more times you can put option C as answer and 10 more times you can put option D as answer. Okay, so like this you need to calculate how many times you kept that option as the answer. And this, once you add your options, you should get total value of 40. Okay, and sincere suggestion, use this cheat code only when you are unable to cross the minimum cutoff. Okay, and you can use this cheat code when you are unable to answer most of the questions. Okay, so ide cheat code ni ippudu telugulo kuda chudam. So first manaki MCET lo MCET question paper lo 160 questions untayi. 160 questions ki 4 options istaru, A B C D. Aa 4 options entante, ఆప్షన్ ఏ అనేది మనకి 40 క్వశ్చన్స్ కి ఆన్సర్గా ఉంటుంది, ఆప్షన్ బి అనేది 40 క్వశ్చన్స్ కి ఆన్సర్ ఉంటుంది, ఆప్షన్ సి 40 క్వశ్చన్స్ కి ఆన్సర్ ఉంటుంది, ఆప్షన్ డి అనేది 40 క్వశ్చన్స్ కి ఆన్సర్ ఉంటుంది. సో అన్నీ కలిపితే మనకి 160 క్వశ్చన్స్ కి 160 ఆప్షన్స్ వస్తాయి. సో ఇప్పుడు ఒకవేళ మీరు కనుక ఆప్షన్ ఏ 35 టైమ్స్ పెట్టారనుకోండి, ఆప్షన్ బి 15 టైమ్స్ పెట్టారు, ఆప్షన్ సి 25 టైమ్స్ పెట్టారు, ఆప్షన్ డి 30 టైమ్స్ పెట్టారు అంటే, సో ఆప్షన్ ఏ 35 టైమ్స్ పెట్టారు కాబట్టి ఇది 40 కన్నా 5 తక్కువ. సో మిగిలిన 5 క్వశ్చన్స్ కి కూడా మీరు ఆప్షన్ ఏ అనేది ఆన్సర్గా పెట్టొచ్చు. ఓకే, ఆప్షన్ బి అనేది మీరు 15 టైమ్స్ ఆన్సర్గా పెట్టారు కాబట్టి ఇంకా 25 టైమ్స్ మీరు ఆప్షన్ బి చూస్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. ఈ చీట్ కోడ్ మీరు ఓన్లీ ఈ చీట్ కోడ్ కట్ ఆఫ్ రీచ్ అవ్వలేకపోతున్నాము అనుకున్న సందర్భంలోనే యూస్ చేయండి. అండ్ ఇంకొక మెయిన్ పాయింట్ వచ్చేసి, ఫస్ట్ 40కి ఆప్షన్ ఏ ఉంటుంది, సెకండ్ 40కి ఆప్షన్ బి ఉంటుంది, ఇది కాదండి. లో ర్యాండమ్గా ఏమైనా 40కి ఆప్షన్ ఏ ఉంటుంది, ఏమైనా 40 క్వశ్చన్స్కి బి ఉంటుంది, అలా ర్యాండమ్గా ఉంటుంది. కంటిన్యూస్గా 1 to 40కి ఆప్షన్ ఏ, 40 to 80కి ఆప్షన్ బి అలా కాదు. మొత్తం పేపర్లో ఎక్కడో ఓ 40 ఆప్షన్స్ ఏ ఉంటాయి, ఎక్కడో 40 ఆప్షన్స్ బి ఉంటాయి అలా అనమాట. మోస్ట్ అదర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ థింగ్ ఇస్ ఫస్ట్ 1 to 40 ఆన్సర్స్ ఆప్షన్ యూ కెన్ పుట్ యాజ్ ఏ అండ్ 41 to 80 యూ కెన్ పుట్ యాజ్ బి. దిస్ ఇస్ నాట్ ద కేస్. ర్యాండమ్లీ యూ హ్యావ్ టు యూస్ దిస్ టెక్నిక్. అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 1 to 160 క్వశ్చన్స్, ఎనీ 40 విల్ హ్యావ్ ఆప్షన్ ఏ యాజ్ ఆన్సర్, ఎనీ 40 విల్ హ్యావ్ ఆప్షన్ బి యాజ్ ఆన్సర్, ఎనీ 40 విల్ హ్యావ్ ఆప్షన్ సి యాజ్ ఆన్సర్, లైక్ దాట్ ఎనీ 40 విల్ హ్యావ్ డి యాజ్ ఆన్సర్. ఓకే, యూ హ్యావ్ టు యూస్ దిస్ చీట్ కోడ్ ఇన్ అ ర్యాండమ్ ఫార్మాట్. ఓకే, ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ వాల్యూస్. నెక్స్ట్ చీట్ కోడ్ ఈస్ నో ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ వాల్యూస్. వాట్ డస్ దిస్ మీన్? ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, లెట్స్ థింక్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ క్వశ్చన్ అండ్ దెర్ ఆర్ 4 ఆప్షన్స్. ఆప్షన్ ఏ ఇస్ 2, ఆప్షన్ బి ఇస్ 4, ఆప్షన్ బి ఇస్ 8, ఆప్షన్ డి ఇస్ 21. ఓకే, సో సి, అవుట్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ 4 ఆప్షన్స్ విచ్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ వాల్యూ, ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ మీన్స్ డిఫరెంట్ వాల్యూ, దిస్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ డిఫరెంట్ వాల్యూ, సో యూ కాంట్ పుట్ దిస్ యాజ్ ఆన్సర్. ఓకే, యూ హ్యావ్ టు గెస్ ఓన్లీ, యూ హ్యావ్ టు పుట్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ 3 ఆప్షన్స్ యాజ్ అ ఆన్సర్. ఓకే, యూ షుడ్ అవాయిడ్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ వాల్యూస్. ఓకే, ఇప్పుడు నో ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ వాల్యూస్ ఈ చీట్ కోడ్ అర్థం ఏంటి ఇప్పుడు మనం చూద్దాం. ఓకే, సో ఒక క్వశ్చన్ ఉంది అండ్ 4 ఆప్షన్స్ ఇచ్చారు, 2, 4, 8, 21. ఇవి 4 వాల్యూస్. ఆ 4 వాల్యూస్లో మొత్తం డిఫరెంట్గా విభిన్నంగా ఉన్న ఆప్షన్ ఏదైతే ఉంది, ఇది 21. మిగిలినవన్నీ దగ్గర దగ్గరగా ఉన్న ఆప్షన్స్, కానీ ఇది మాత్రం చాలా డిఫరెంట్గా ఉంది. ఇలాంటి డిఫరెంట్ ఆప్షన్ని మాత్రం పెట్టుకోవద్దు. గెస్ చేస్తున్నప్పుడు దీన్ని అవాయిడ్ చేయండి. మిగిలిన 3లోనే ఒక ఆన్సర్ అనేది మీరు పెట్టుకోవచ్చు. ఓకేనా? సో నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్, నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్. Next is all of the above and none of the above. See, when you have all of the above as one of the option, you can go for it. You have all of the above as one of the option and you don't know what is the correct answer, then there are high chances that all of the above is the correct answer. Then you can happily go for it, okay? And if you find none of the above as one of the option and if you don't know what is the correct answer, don't go for it, okay? There are very least probabilities of none of the above being the correct answer, okay? So that's why always go for all of the above and never go for none of the above, okay? So, ipudu manam all of the above, none of the above options ento chuddam, okay? Oka question undi, a question options vachesi all of the above undi and meeku answer correct ga telikapothe appudu meeru all of the above anedi pettochu endukante chaala chances unnai all of the above correct avadaniki. So ilante appudu meeru all of the above option choose chesukochu. Second entante meeku మీకు ఇచ్చిన ఆప్షన్స్లో నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌ ఉంది అండ్ మీకు ఆ కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ తెలీదు అన్నప్పుడు నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌ చూస్ చేసుకోకండి. ఎందుకంటే చాలా తక్కువ కేసులో, చాలా తక్కువ ఛాన్సెస్లో నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌ అనేది కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ అవుతుంది, సరేనా? నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్. నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్? When you have four options, using your logic, using the concept which you know which is related to this question, try to eliminate the irrelevant options, okay? So then out of four options, after eliminating the irrelevant options, you will be left with only two options. Then you can happily guess and put one of these options, okay? This is called elimination method. Using your logic and your common sense and the concept which you know related to the question, just eliminate irrelevant options, okay? So ipudu manam elimination method ante ento chuddam. Elimination method entante oka question lo four options iste meeku ఆ కాన్సెప్ట్, మీకు ఆ క్వశ్చన్కి సంబంధించిన కాన్సెప్ట్ గుర్తు తెచ్చుకొని కామన్ సెన్స్ ఉపయోగించుకుని ఫోర్ ఆప్షన్స్లో టూ ఆప్షన్స్ మీరు ఎలిమినేట్ చేసేయండి, రిమూవ్ చేసేయండి. అప్పుడు మిగిలిన ఆప్షన్స్లో ఒక ఆన్సర్ మీరు పెట్టొచ్చు కరెక్ట్గా గెస్ చేసి. దీన్ని ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్ అంటారు. సో నౌ లెట్స్ సీ ఎంసెట్ మార్క్స్ వర్సెస్ ర్యాంక్. ఫస్ట్ లెట్ సీ ఫోర్ ఇంజనీరింగ్, ఆఫ్టర్ దిస్ లెట్ సీ ఫోర్ for medical and agricultural, okay? So after seeing MCET marks versus rank, we are also going to see this year's MCET cutoff category wise, okay? So coming to engineering and MCET marks versus rank, for marks they are going to consider MCET weightage and inter weightage also, okay? And they are going to add both of them. If your MCET weightage plus inter weightage is 98, then you're going to get first rank. So you will get 100 rank if your marks are 89, okay? So if your marks are 78, you're going to get 1000 rank. If your marks are 67, you're going to get 5000 rank. Like this, you need to add your MCET weightage and inter weightage in order to get your marks, okay? So if you get 61 marks, you're going to get 10,000 rank. If your marks are 47, your rank will be around 50,000. And if your marks are 41, your rank will be around 1 lakh. Okay. So now let's see for medical and agricultural. If your MCET weightage and inter weightage is 98.3, you're going to get first rank. If your marks are 92.12, if your MCET plus inter weightage is 92.12, your rank is going to be 100. So like this, by adding both MCET and inter weightage, they are going to estimate your percentage, okay? Now let's see expected cutoff, okay? Expected cutoff category wise, right? So first, coming to unreserved candidates or general candidates, cutoff is going to be 45, okay? And for SC ST is going to be 35. Okay, so this year's expected cutoff. Okay, so yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. For this video especially, our team has worked very hard to make a long video for you. So guys, please support our channel so that we are going to make more and more such kind of useful and helpful videos for you guys. So please don't forget to like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that whenever I make a new video, you will be getting notification, you will receive notifications. So let's help this video reach 1k likes, and let's help our channel reach 20k subscribers so soon. Okay, so yeah, all the very best for your exam. And guys, my sincere request, please wear mask, make sure you carry your small sanitizer, and also don't forget to maintain social distancing. At the end of the day, life is very important. But so yeah, all the very best for your exam, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon.